So, I must say, this was an amazing season finale, in every way. Yes, things are going to be straightforward here. By the way, spoilers. Duh. Now, first, a quick recap on the things that really worked about the season finale. Some of the greatest things about the episode were the constant references to many of the show's best inside jokes. They were everywhere in this episode. For example, the "Have you met Ted?" and the Canada jokes, and the "It's never that" opened the episode, setting up the tone for the rest of it. Every reference was both hilarious because of nostalgia, and nostalgic because even as the seasons have passed, it is still hilarious, and it makes us think back to all of the times in which we have fallen flat on our asses with laughter. The finale takes us back to the very first episode to continue to tell the amazing story. These jumps in time are amazingly well executed. There are literally like a billion timelines that are unfolding simultaneously to tell a main story in the middle of the timeline. It is insane to think how difficult this could be, but surprisingly, the creators were able to show their six skills at storytelling once again. Very well played. Once again, the references to earlier episodes were everywhere. It is amazing how many they stopped using. Who even remembered the "Look at me, Ted, look at me"? That was hilarious. It was nice to see it once again. And who the hell even saw the Liberty Bell thing coming? That was unexpected. While at the station where Ted meets the mother, I really like to see the old lady as a little angel in Ted's shoulder, telling him to chase destiny, and Ted fighting with himself because of what he has supposedly learned. That was a brilliant move right there. The constant flash forwards and backwards were masterfully directed and flowed perfectly. Many people seem to look that over, but it is really damn hard to do, I think. The Cockamouse and Halloween Roof Party made me very happy to remember those awesome episodes and also began to show Robin's separation from the group. Robin and Lily's conversation was especially brilliant. It felt like a real friendship coming to some sort of an end. The best thing about it was that it was realistic and heartbreaking. It actually made me feel very angry at Robin, like really angry and disappointed. That is great storytelling when the creators are able to do that. Also, great acting by both. Very convincing. Ted and Tracy's ballad costume was a personal highlight. Now that is a smart and very cute joke. Now, my second favorite moment was the whole conclusion of Barney's arc. It was introduced by the Perfect Week and Robots vs. Wrestlers gimmick, and then followed with the "just okay" and the return of the playbook, which were hilarious callbacks to some of the best moments of the series. It is especially effective because after we learn of Barney's sometimes pathetic attitudes towards life after the divorce, we see one of the most powerful and honest forces of life, love for one's kids. He truly meets the love of his life here. We see Barney achieve happiness through his own way, becoming a father, unlike how his friends and even the viewers of the show wanted to see him achieve it. The scene that him and his daughter share is simply one of the most beautiful scenes I have ever seen on television. We see Barney realize what is truly important in his life. Not sentimental relationships, not committing to anybody, just fatherhood. His speech was a whole new level of touching beauty. Hats off. Besides, the "Not a Father's Day" callback was unexpected, and awesome, of course. I also finished falling in love with the mother and Ted's relationship. Their sense of humor is my absolute favorite in any show. No exaggeration. Now, finally, the big moment. The scene in which he meets her is as every bit as sweet, funny, and amazing as I had always hoped it to be. It was simply perfect. The jokes were appropriate, and the chemistry these two shared was unbelievable. It really was the best moment in the whole series, at least for me. The mother's name reveal was done in great taste. Very clever how they use the initials TM as both Tracy McClure and the mother. Brilliant move. I also love their little arguments over who owned the umbrella. They both did, and it was the biggest symbol of hope and mystery in the series, along with the blue French horn. That was the biggest difference between Ted and Tracy. He embraced it. He needed the yellow umbrella in his life, while Tracy was too afraid to cling to something new after his fiancé's death. One of my favorite little details that Tentico noticed. Now you guys know. This is exactly why I feel the ending is so appropriate, but more on that later. Also, quick note. We always knew what the mother's name was. At the end of an episode called The Belly Full of Turkey, we see Ted teasing his kids with a stripper named Tracy. He jokingly tells them that she is their mother. And well, I gotta say, I totally saw that one coming, but yet, it was a great move. Great move, How I Met Your Mother. And then, the series concludes where it started, with Ted embracing the blue French horn one last time. Because that is who he is, that is what he has always been and will be. The shot of Robin looking out the windows with her dogs was nostalgic and makes me think of Romeo and Juliet a little bit. In Shakespearean drama, by the way, the characters that seem to be outside the action, such as the nurse in Romeo and Juliet and Horatio in Hamlet, are the ones that are able to see clearly through things, and usually carry the voice of truth and reason. Ted's kids serve this purpose in How I Met Your Mother, and, as Horatio and the nurse, they were right. This is exactly what Carter and Thomas accomplished, and I would not be surprised to find out that is exactly what they were aiming for. They both studied literature, for God's sakes. This was definitely the perfect way to conclude this amazing series. Back to square one, with Ted realistically remaining as he had always been, as the hopeless romantic with the blue French horn. I must admit, in the beginning I simply did not know how to react to the finale. I was surely upset about how the story actually ended, but as I thought more and more about it, I came to realize how realistically everything was handled in the end. Now, many hardcore fans of the show, such as myself, will initially feel furious at the fact that, in the end, many of the lessons that were supposed to have been learned in these past 9 years were completely useless. Since Barney and Robin got back to their old self after the divorce, and since Ted, obviously, ends up returning to Robin once again. Now, the ending that Carter and Thomas chose was very questionable, of course, but there is no denying that it had guts. The fans were expecting a happy ending, do not bullshit me. I think that the majority were hoping to see Barney and Robin magically overcome all of their differences and settle down forever. The show definitely appeared to be driving towards that direction at some points. All of the battles and the way in which we had seen both Barney and Robin evolve, although very moving, were just not real. It was a product of the situation. That is not how life works, and that is the key word for this finale, real. The finale episode was probably among the most realistic How I Met Your Mother episodes ever. We finally got to see how real life tends to work. Life mistakes do happen, and even when we are sure that we have changed, there is no way to change the way we are, no matter how hard we try. It had always been obvious that Barney and Robin were simply not meant to be together. They always ignored the clear differences that they so obviously shared. Their relationship was not a healthy one. It was destructive, obsessive, and, as it was said many times, simply did not make any sense whatsoever. If I had to choose a single scene to describe How I Met Your Mother, it would have to be the one in which Barney tells Lily, "That's me. Can I just please be me?" This is mostly one of the most important ideas that the whole series was pursuing. You cannot change who you are. It is not healthy to do so, and Robin and Barney's relationship clearly shows this. Barney will always be the sick, awesome guy with the insecurity issues, just as Ted will always be the hopeless romantic, and Robin the woman that locks herself up in her career. In the end, the characters did not change much, did they? They were not supposed to. Your nature is not something you can change, and much less something you should want to change. What I really loved about the episode is that it was extremely realistic. People do make mistakes, such as the ones that Barney, Ted, and Robin have made. And when they do, you get angry at them, and you cannot understand why the hell they won't change, despite your advice. Carter and Thomas created characters that were so amazingly relatable that you react to their poor life decisions in similar ways that you would react to the poor life decisions made by your friends, or even your own. Many people expected a happy Disney ending, and I am extremely glad that they didn't go that way. And I am not just talking about the fact that the mother dies. The show had the balls to say, "We all make mistakes, and we will never change who we are. That is not life. Life is not a fairy tale. Some things are just not meant to be. Even with the best of advice or with the most tragic of events, we tend to gravitate towards the mistakes we have already made." Many people say that one reaches maturity when you realize that it doesn't exist, and this show is an amazing proof of that statement. Besides, Barney does really discover what is important in his life. His daughter. He stopped lying to himself by saying that he wanted to settle down and marry. That was just not him, and, in many ways, that is the happiest of endings. Self-acceptance and discovery of something beautiful within you that you never knew you had. It was also very nice that they gave him a daughter. It was kind of predictable, but it was the kind of predictable that's very sweet. It is obvious that Ted adored his wife, the mother of his children, but he realized that he is not a person made to linger in the past. He is the holder of the blue French horn and the yellow umbrella, symbols for hope and lust for the unknown. He didn't really change much, he gained wisdom that he shares with his children and us, but, just as him, we will never be able to really listen. Then, Robin came to realize that she could not change who she was. She tried to be like Lillian Marshall, she wanted to, but life proved her wrong. Marshall and Lily had the happiest of endings, because they were blessed with finding love early in life, and that is also something that can happen in real life, I mean, it's not something unheard of, and that is exactly why they had such a heavy influence on their friends. They have what many want and look for in life, but many times it is also something that they don't need, that they don't really need. The season finale was everything that it should have been. It was beautiful, hilarious, and extremely conclusive. It proved once and for all that the writers not only are brilliant storytellers, but also proved that they were trying to communicate a valuable life lesson, which is both sad and, when you realize it, wonderful. My verdict, How I Met Your Mother will go down in history as one of the funniest, better written, and just best television shows of all time. And it has a finale to support that statement. And I guess one could say that this show will continue to linger into our minds for the longest time. Thank you.
For the longest time, whoa, for the longest time, if you said goodbye to me tonight, there would still be music left to write. What else could I do? I'm so inspired by you. That hasn't happened for the longest time.